my presentation. Gently, in your case, Burma. I'm from Burma. The location is from the center of Japan, about 100 kilometers north of Tokyo. Recently, President of Vietnam visited Burma Prefecture because now 7,000 Vietnamese live in Burma Prefecture. In 2020, we will have Tokyo Olympics. So if you come to Japan, please visit Burma. Today, I will talk about characteristics of rheumatoid arthritis, including onset and imaging. After that, I will introduce the recent work about rigid bed and joint reflection. First, let me talk about rheumatoid arthritis. He is a French artist bloomer, and we can see the joint destruction. Although he had a severe deformity in his hand, now we can see his beautiful hands all over the world. Rheumatoid arthritis is a common identity-specific inflammatory disease affecting about 1% of the worldwide population. RA is characterized by synovial inflammation and hyperplasia of antibody production, cartilage, and bone destruction. Typical symptoms include tender, bone, swollen joint, joint stiffness, that is usually worse in the morning, fatigue, fever, and weight loss. Normal joint is a left panel, and in the rheumatoid arthritis, inflamed synovium leads to the bone and cartilage destruction, leading to joint deformity. When doing the operation, compared with the synovium of the arthritis, the left panel, every patient had a severe inflamed synovium in the joint. So if we do the total knee arthroplasty, we need to resect this synovium. In the RA joint, there are increased inflammatory cells, and fibroblasts and macrophages are important cell types because they release cytokines into the whole body. In the synovium of RA, we can see the synovial cell hyperplasia and focal aggregate of lymphocytes. And symptoms of RA are not only limited in the joint, but release cytokine also affects all over the body. Usually, CRP is high, and RA patients have a high rate of myocardial infarction and stroke, depression, low bone mineral density, which leading to fracture. So what causes rheumatoid arthritis? Recently, some kind of risk factor for RA have been found. The first is genetics. If there are some problems with genes related to the immune system, the rate of RA can increase. Another factor is environment, such as smoking and periodontitis, which interact with the genetic factor, and this interaction leads to the pre-arthritic condition. So, environment and genetic factors are important for the development of RA. The major risk factor for RA are women, the age is between 40 and 60, family history, smoking, pregnancy, and environmental exposures such as bacteria, asbestos, and silica. This is a typical MRI image with our patient. Compared to the baseline, we can see the severe erosion at 12 months later. And this is my patient. We can not see severe erosion in the both hands, but her CRP level was 80 mg per deciliter, 80 mg per liter. And this is same patient at same time. There was tendonitis around flexor tendon and extensor tendons. These signs are important to diagnose RA in early phase. We can also see the synovitis around the carpal bone. Another imaging modality is ultrasound, and PD method is useful to check the information of synovitis, although the quality of image depends on the physician technique. So what can we see using FDG PET for our patient? FDG PET can detect synovitis in patients with RA. We can see the uptake to the major joint in the body. The right panel is the FDG PET uptake, FDG uptake to shoulder joints. And the FDG uptake to the joints decreases after successful treatment. This is a 60-year-old female. After 6 months with under TNF therapy, FDG uptake had decreased. When we use anti-interleukin 6 antibody drugs, the CRP and ESR levels decrease quickly just after the drug injection. However, we can see subclinical arthritis with FDG PET. These are the images under interleukin 6 therapy from baseline to 6 months. At 3 months, this patient's CRP and ESR were normal. However, we can still see the FDG uptake in his body. Previously, there are several kinds of basic research regarding to the FDG uptakes to the joint. This is the animal model, animal RA model, having high FDG uptakes to the joint. And from these previous reports, FDG uptake depends on the severity of the arthritis inflammation. So we completed a study to check the relationship between FDG uptake and histological assessment in human RA patients. We took FDG PET the day before operation, the total knee arthroplasty operation, and collected the synovium at the operation. And we scored section according to the Unis score. Then analyze the relationship between these scores and FDG PET. The result was that joint FDG uptake had significant correlation with synovial hyperplasia and diffuse infiltrate of lymphocytes. So can we predict the joint destruction in RA patient using FDG PET? This is one example of the progression of joint destruction. 67 years old female, and her baseline FDG uptake in the left elbow can be seen, and the SD mean is 2.1. After 4 years, we can see the severe job destruction. And traditionally, we evaluate a rate joint using Larsen grade. And this is the 5 grade score. And we analyzed 54 joints for 5 years. And the SD at the baseline was significantly correlated with changes in X-ray grade. After logistic analysis, higher SAD and lower prebendal dose were associated with progressive joint destruction. And based on the ROC analysis, the threshold for identifying preceding joint destruction was SAD mean of 1.33. So from this study, the MDG updates might be associated with future radiographic changes in RA patients. But this study investigated a patient with traditional oral drugs. It means these patients were without recent anti-cytokine therapy. Now we have several anti-cytokine therapy, such as DNA blocking therapy. And even under this therapy, we can see joint destruction. So next, we analyze joint destruction under anti-cytokine therapy. Among 30 RA shoulder joints, 10 shoulder has progression of destruction during 3 years. And based on the logistic analysis, in this one, SAD was the main risk factor for shoulder joint destruction. And the threshold for the joint destruction was SAD max 1.57 at baseline. So next question is, how are the other joints, such as knee and wrist? To answer this question, we perform another analysis of total to 264 joints for 2 years. These joints include shoulder, elbow, wrist, hip, knee, and ankle joint. Radiographic progression of joint destruction was detected in 33 large joints. These are the SAD max in the joint with or without radiographic progression. There is significant higher SAD max with progression group, both at baseline and 6 months. And to determine parameters with independent predictive value for joint destruction, multivariate logistic analysis was performed. And as a result, that's 28. This is activity score of immunoarthritis at 6 months, and SUV at baseline were significant independent predictor for joint destruction in 2 years. So now we know the SUV at baseline is an important parameter for the joint destruction. However, our assessment was based on the Larsen grade, so some small progression cannot be detected. While this patient had a small progression of destruction in her wrist, for 2 years, the Larsen grade was the same. Therefore, we used a RAS scoring system. This is a new scoring system. And based on the status score and change score. For example, this 80-year-old man had a severe MDG uptake, SAD max 5.83 at baseline. And RAS status score was 1 at baseline. He got an intensive therapy with anti-interleukin 6 receptor antibody, and his RAS changing score was won after 3 years. And after receiving analysis, SV max 1.65 and more at baseline was a significant value that predict joint disruption at 3 years after initiation of biologic therapy. This is the summary of this presentation. FGC-PET can detect synovitis in the joint of patient with rheumatoid arthritis. Joint FGC uptakes correlate with synovial site hyperplasia and diffuse infiltrate of lymphocytes. The SV at baseline is a significant factor to predict the joint disruption. Thank you for your attention.